Hi everyone. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and discuss how to write the formulas for ionic compounds. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the first step is we want to write the cation first. Remember, that's going to be the metal, and then the anion second. And we want to use this little template, the line box, because it's going to help make sure we put everything in its correct spot. Next, we're going to crisscross the superscript numbers to fill in the boxes. So the charges that we write up top with the ions, we swap them and they go to the opposite element. And then if necessary, we're going to reduce the superscript number. So if we have two and two in our box, we can reduce that to one and one. Okay, so the next thing is we want to go ahead and place the cation on the first line and then the anion on the second line. And then we ask ourselves some questions. First of all, are there any polyatomic ions? And if so, do we have more than one of them? So if we look at the box following that polyatomic ion, is there a number in there greater than one? So if we say no to either question, we don't need parentheses. But if we say yes to either question, then we need to add parentheses around the polyatomic ion. And we'll see an example of that. And then finally, we're going to go ahead and rewrite our answer without those lines and boxes so that looks nice and neat. Okay, so let's go ahead and work through an example. So we have magnesium and oxygen, and we have our template set up here. So magnesium is plus two and it goes on the first line. Oxygen is minus two and goes on the second line. We're then going to crisscross those superscripts and fill in the boxes. So the positive two for magnesium goes into that second box. And then the minus two from the oxygen goes into the first box. Once we have this done, we want to erase those positive and negative signs because we no longer need them. The positive and negative are talking about charges. When we have the boxes filled in those subscripts, that's talking about how many atoms we have, and we can't have negative oxygen. Does it make sense? So Mg2O2. And in this case, if we think about it, we can go ahead and reduce that to one and one because both numbers are divisible by two. So final step, if we think about it, we don't have any polyatomic ions, so we don't need to worry about that. But final step is going to be rewriting this to get MgO. Okay, the next example, calcium phosphate. So we have calcium, Ca plus 2, and phosphate, which is PO4 minus 3. Again, we're going to take our superscript numbers up top and crisscross them down below. So the 2 from calcium goes into the last box, and the minus 3 from phosphate goes into the first box. Then we go ahead and get rid of those positive and negative signs. We don't need them anymore. And we have a few questions to ask ourselves. Can we reduce this? Nope. Next, do I have any polyatomic ions? Yes. And do I have more than one of them? So I look at my box, I have two. So yes, I do have more than one. So I'm going to go ahead and put parentheses around the ion. So PO4, I put parentheses around it. The parentheses are important because they help to separate the polyatomic ion, that PO4, from that number two, so we can tell where everything is coming from. Okay, so final step then is we're going to go ahead and rewrite our final answer. So Ca3 parentheses PO4 and then 2 on the outside. Okay, so thanks for watching everyone. I hope this helps. If you have any questions, please let me know. Bye.